if you ignore actual human behavior, you're going to keep coming up with these plans that look really good on paper, but never actually come to fruition in real life. Things happen, right? And so the balance is in business and life and nutrition and in anything, it's not here is what is perfect on paper. It is here is the best I can actually do in the real world, right? It's not, you know, in the real world, I'd only eat chicken, rice, and salad. If I'm not going to actually do that, that is not the best method for me. And business is the same way. There's added complexities and like, what will I actually do? What will my business partner actually do? What will my employees actually do? And when you start measuring, okay, in theory, Lisa, what's up? If I said, Lisa, this one needs to get done. This is high leverage. You identify the high leverage activities. What can you do? What can I do? What can Dan do? What can Monica do? What can Vita do, right? So this is how we assume we're going to operate next week. And then we go through the week and we come back and look at what we actually got done. There's always a discrepancy. And then we start examining why was there a discrepancy, right? And what happens as an organization, we start learning not what looks perfect in a perfect world. Like if we lived in a vacuum, what would I get done? We actually start making decisions based on what we know as individuals and as a team, we can actually get done. And so every single week we set these high leverage tasks, task them out, and they get done without fail. Because we use theory, we use what looks good on paper, and then we use the science of hindsight. This is what should happen next week. This is what actually happened. Why? Why the discrepancy? So then we fix the things that actually happened, but we also adjust our theories over what we're going to get done. And what happens is this gap, this intention intervention gap between what we know we should be doing or think we should be doing and what we're actually doing every day, every week, every month, every year shrinks. And when that happens, you can grow at an exponential rate. You don't waste any energy at all. Maximum productivity, maximum profit, because there's no waste, right? So it's this is what we should, in theory, get done based on our current mental models, you know, which who knows where they came from. And then here's our plan. Here's what happened in the real world. Now, using the science of hindsight, not foresight, which is entirely inaccurate, using the science of hindsight, we say, okay, this is what actually happened. Why did this happen instead of this? We eliminate whatever barriers we can, and then we adjust our mental models. And every week, we eliminate barrier, adjust the mental model. Eliminate barrier, adjust mental model. So if you have marketing issues, the velocity framework will get you over them. If you have operational issues, the velocity framework will get you over them, right? If you have hiring, firing, partnership issues, productivity issues, margin, issues with your margins, with your supply chain, with your suppliers, this is the framework that shows you how to sit down, figure out how to solve the problem, come up with a plan, dial that plan in, execute it, move on.